الله وبركاته. الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه. Before I start, I want to ask a few questions. Is there any college student here? Could you please raise your hand? If you go to college, okay, one, two. High school students. Okay, good. Middle school? Okay, middle school too, mashallah. I don't want to go elementary, that's okay, but I think some elementary or non-school non-goer here. So I need your attention here. And this is, I came from Virginia, and I will say that especially for you I came here. And I think part of this arrangement is for you. So please pay attention, and please don't walk unless you need to. So first thing, I put it this way, the five pillars of parenting based on principles of Quran and Sunnah are from Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The first thing is love. Love from both sides. This I want to say to parents and children. Based on the Quran, one of the ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنْفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً إِنَّ فِي ذَٰلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِقَوْمٍ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. Another verse Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَظًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَانْفَضُّوا مِنْ حَوْلِهِ وَشَاوِرْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ فَاعْفُ عَنْهُمْ وَاسْتَغْفِرْهُمْ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ وَشَاوِرْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ فَإِذَا عَزَمْتَ فَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَيْهِ اللَّهِ. So the first verse, because of time, I'll not give very details, but that's I'm talking about family. That's one of the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us a family, created us from our parent. لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً. To live with the peace. So my request to parents, and of course, it is undoubtedly every parent loves their children, especially mothers. However, the format of love is the following verse, inshallah, how to love, how to express, and these other pillars, these other points actually will say how to express your love. So from the children's side, actually I have one son, he's 18, and I have two daughters, 5 and 3. So, of course, 18 years old, he's a teenager, he passed teenage. So one of the things I would like to say all teenagers, even sometimes, especially when you go to teenage, you do have some conflict, something with your parent, either mother or father. But you need to have this firm faith that your mom and dad, your parent love you, unconditional. And you have to have same way. Even you have some conflict sometimes. So, as I said, first thing, you have to have a love and respect. And the following verse, the فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that this is Allah's blessings, even though some of us sitting says a different circumstances, especially in social aspect. However, I think it goes to the parenting and family as well. That this is Allah's blessing that you have, you have that sweet heart. You have a nice heart that if you were harsh, then they will run away from you. So I think this is especially for fathers. Some fathers, especially Desi cultures or Arab cultures, fathers are what we tough. So I think this advice especially for fathers, even the hard situation, you have to be a little loving to them and more compassionate to them. Then Allah said, فَعْفُ عَنْهُمْ. If they do any mistake, any problem, the kids do problem, you have to forgive them. وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ. Ask for their forgiveness. وَشَاوِرْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ. This is one of the very important things, especially for parents. وَشَاوِرْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ. Consult with your children. Usually this is not in our culture, we don't discuss about family matters with our children. So, this is very important, especially in family matters, if it's related to their life, you should discuss with them. Then Allah says, وَشَابِلُ فَإِذَا عَزَمْتَ فَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ. Then, of course, finally, after final decision, you have to be firm. And especially even disciplining kids, disciplining your children, you have to be firm. The second pillar is best moral character. As some brothers have mentioned before, of course, as we know, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. And also another verse, Rasulullah said, as it was recited before, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِمُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. Now, in family, it is very important. I think a few years back, probably 2016, 17 or 15 or 16, same thing, that even if you read social science book, I read in John Maxwell's leadership book, that a single crack in your character, that's one example is, somebody call at your home, your kid pick up the phone, for some reason you do not want to talk to that person, you say, tell dad is not at home, you made a big mess. Please don't do this, because you have to have a strong moral character. I think Islamically, Bunani Sagira, small sin, sometimes small sin we ignore it. But in family matter, the small sin also very important. If you do small sin, those cracks will make a big problem. So this is another thing that you have to have a strong moral character. And also sometimes we drive, if you didn't stop at a stop sign, or there's a red light, you violate the red light. These things bear disrespect for you. So don't do it. And also, if you tell your son, your daughter, that I'm going to buy this for you, yes, keep the word. If you cannot buy, say, I'm sorry, I cannot buy, I don't have money, or for some any reason. But don't play with them. If you play with them, you lose respect. So this is another principle or pillar of parenting a family life. Third thing is, lift the spirit of children and parents, for both sides. Lift means, you have to have a good word. And one of the things is sadaqa. You have to, after love, with the love, you have to think of big for them. Usually parents do, like what they want to hide. Always encourage them something good, even not only education, not only money-making education, how they can be moral, they have a moral character. So every single thing, every day you can teach them. Like one of the things, recently I was listening to a speech from one of the self-development scholar. He was saying that even holding the door, let's say, or let's say wiping some dirt, even in hadith, of course, I think one of the hadith, I forgot the Arabic, that the best reward is to give the picking up the dirt from the street. So, the thing is, all these small things, this moral character, lift the spirit of the. When you do some these kind of good thing, cleaning, we Muslims are dirty. We don't clean the street. We don't clean our neighbors, our houses. So, small thing, washing you, even at home, washing things. By doing this, you lift up the spirit. And also another most important thing, of course, smiling sadaqa. Then also hadith says, "Muru awladakum bis salat, wahum abna sab'a sinin." That order or command your children to pray when they are seven. And hadith says, "Bid them or like punish them if they don't pray when they are 10." However, basically, point here is that live them by the prayer, spiritual life, spirit. So, and the fourth, part of this is to elevate their spirit is communicate with them, talk to them. If you, especially when they are reaching teenage, or they are already in teenage, 16, 17, 15, of course they have different, nowadays of course all this, iPod, iPad, they stay in their room, you stay in your room. No, you have to sit down with them, every day you have to eat with them, pray with them, take to the masjid, sit down in the prayer at home with them and play with them. Usually we don't play with the children. Yes, we have to play with the children as well. So basically you have to be part of this. And also another thing, connect with them. Previously said contact with them, be in contact with them, communicate with them. Here is a connect. Connection is basically, I think I gave the best example I see here. In hadith about ihsan, Rasulullah said, that ihsan is when you pray like you see Allah. That's called connection. That's the saying in every culture. Actually, one of the even American guy one day telling me, if something happens to a kid, can you imagine who knows the, if nobody saw it, but who can imagine first?
Mother.
That's called connection. If anything good happened to a child, a person, the first person knows, feels, is the mother. And if anything wrong happens, that knows, it goes to the mother. Mother can know it. That's called connection. So father and children also, you have to have that same kind of connection. Connection has to have a lot of effort to build it. Then number four is guide your children to be a leader. Allah said in the Quran, وَالَّذِينَ يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا هَبْ لَنَا مِنْ أَزْوَاجِنَا وَذُرِّيَّتِنَا قُرَّةَ أَعْيُنٍ وَجَعَلْنَا لِلْمُتَّقِينَ إِمَامًا. That's the criteria to raise your children, that to make them imam, leader, imam of the muttaqin. So there are a lot of other criteria or principles how you do that. I have only 5 more minutes. I'll quickly go. But one thing is, you have to have your own moral character. They follow every single thing you see. One of the things I'm sure every parent know, that especially 4 or 5 year old kids, they act sometimes strange. Well, everything they see, they will act it. They will follow it. And also listen to them. When you are reading newspaper, you're watching TV, you are even watching. No, when your kid comes to you, want to talk to you about something, look at them, pay attention. Because that's also build connection. You have to listen to them. Also, eye contact. So that's the also listening skills. But most importantly, as I said, to connect you to a parent-child relationship, you have to listen very carefully. And become a person of integrity. Rasul al-Amin. Trustworthy. Your children should be able to trust you. That father, mother, someone fully trustworthy. The last pillar is make the successful family. Actually, that's what I get from Surah Al-Hujurat, Surah Al-Mu'minun. Even though it's, of course, Surah Al-Mu'minun. So, Allah said, أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتٍ خَاشِعُونَ. One of the meaning of khushu is focus and concentration. I think in family, it is very important to concentrate to each other, to focus, to pay attention to each other. And then avoid unnecessary things. If you do foolish things with your children, you lose respect. You lose family value. Avoid unnecessary things. And wallazin, pay financial obligations. If you don't spend, your children need books, and you have money, if you are cheap, you will lose respect. At the same time, don't waste your money. Don't spend too much. Don't buy too much things. And then, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِفُرُوجِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ. Modesty. That's also another most important thing in the family life. And then, trustworthy. Being punctual. Also, the Quranic verse, وَالَّذِينَ صَلَوَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ. I see the social aspect. That when you go to masjid, take your children. That is very helpful. Who is your friends? Who are your friends in the masjid? If you take them to the masjid, they will be their friends. So, last thing, before I conclude, just a reminder, 3 verses and 1 hadith. 3 verses as one of them I decided. One of them is, Allahu ja'ala lakum min anfusikum azwajan, wa ja'ala lakum min azwajikum banina wa hafadatan. وَرَزَقَكُمْ مِنَ الطَّيِّبَاتِ أَفَبِالْبَاطِلِ يُؤْمِنُونَ وَبِنِعْمَةِ يَكْفُرُونَ. The meaning basically is, of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us and our children, our family. That Allah says, أَفَبِالْبَطْرِ يُؤْمِنُونَ وَبِنِعْمَةِ اللَّهِ يَكْفُرُونَ. Are you refusing Allah's blessings? And then following verse, you will be punished. So this is, we have a reminder that our family is Allah's blessings. We should not deny, refuse it. And second verse is, as most of the وَقَدَى رَبُّكَ لَا تَعْبُدُ إِلَّهُ وَبِالْوَالِدِينَ إِحْسَانًا إِمَّا يَبْلُغَنَّ عِنْدَكَ الْكِبَرَ أَحَدُهُمَا أَوْ كِلَاهُمَا فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍّ وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا وَقُلْ لَهُمَا قَوْلًا كَرِيمًا وَاخْفِضْ لَهُمَا جَنَاحَ الذُّلِّ مِنَ الرَّحْمَةِ وَقُلْ رَبِّ ارْحَمْهُمَا كَمَا رَبَّيَانِي صَغِيرًا. This is especially for the kids, children. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is Allah ta'abudu illa iyyah. Don't worship anybody else except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Do your best job, excellent job, ihsan with your parents. Then Allah says, إِمَّا يَبْلُغَنَّ عِنْدَكَ الْكِبَرَ أَحَدُهُمَا أَوْ كِلَاهُمَا. When they get old, you became big man, money making, or for any reason. That's the dangerous time. So don't say any bad word or anything bad about them or any disrespectful to them. And then be kind to them, take care of them. And the last hadith for all parents and children, please pay attention. Then I'll conclude. Just hadith. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "إذا مات الإنسان انقطع عنه عمله إلا ثلاث." When a human being dies, everything, you know, if recently somebody died, he could be richest person in the world, he could be most powerful, most famous, most known, most knowledgeable. Everything is gone, but only three things remains. What are those three things? Sadaqatun jariya, any sadaqa, with sadaqa jariya, continuous sadaqa. You know, I'm sure you've heard hadith many times. You go to school, you go to madrasa, and then ilmun yuntafa'u bihi, your ilm. If you are a teacher, you are a professor, you taught children, you build some, that is sadaqa jariya. And last thing, most important, waladun salihun yad'u lahu. For parents, if you raise a child, if you teach them Quran, if your child know how to make dua for you, they will make dua for you. And children, that's the most important when your parent goes. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq. O ma tawfiq illa billah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
ITV, call of peace, save humanity.